Experience one of the most famous vistas in the world, captured on a perfect summer morning. This is beautiful Lake Louise in the Canadian Rockies. Heading into the Rockies of Alberta, we continue past the town of Banff to beautiful Lake Louise. We enjoy an early morning stroll along the scenic shore to where the glacial meltwaters rush down the mountain into a gentle delta feeding the lake. On our return, the lake shares more of its sunlit picturesque views as canoers glide by. Lake Louise was first settled as a construction camp for the Canadian Pacific Railroad in 1884. A station was built, which also then served as a base for rail line construction through the Kicking Horse Pass. The station is now a restaurant in the Lake Louise village. A couple years before, Tom Wilson, who was working for the Canadian Pacific Railroad, was camping in the area with his Stoney Nakoda First Nations guide when they heard avalanches in the distance. Indigenous people had lived in the foothills of the Canadian Rocky Mountains long before the European settlers arrived. His guide said the sound was coming from Snow Mountain above the Lake of the Little Fishes. Well, they ventured up to the lake, and after standing before it, Tom said, "As God is my judge, I never in all my explorations saw such a matchless scene." He called it Emerald Lake. It would then be renamed to Lake Louise after Princess Louise Caroline Alberta, the fourth daughter of Queen Victoria. And the province of Alberta also got its name from this princess. Lake Louise has one of the most famous vistas in the world. Its emerald green color comes from the rock dust carved off the mountain by glaciers and carried into the lake by the meltwater. Mount Victoria, named after Queen Victoria, sits right behind the lake on the Continental Divide, with the province of British Columbia on the other side. Lake Louise doesn't thaw until the end of May and sometimes early June. For our video, we see it at the end of July. In 1896, Canada reported its first mountain climbing fatality here, prompting the hiring of experienced Swiss guides to lead adventurous tourists into the mountains. And the Swiss guides lived in this log cabin on the lake from 1922 until 1956, and it's now a private residence. Just behind this ridge is Canada's highest historic site. After the fatality, Swiss guides recommended building the Abbott Pass hut for an overnight stay. Built in 1922, it's still operational and advanced hikers can reserve it through the Alpine Club of Canada. Reaching it is rated difficult and requires preparation and hiking gear. As the popularity of Lake Louise grew, the Canadian Pacific Railway built a hotel on the lake, which was later reconstructed into the chateau we see today. The railway also developed hiking trails, shelters, and tea houses, which are still operational. A popular hike branches off near the chateau to a 3.5 kilometer trail leading up to Agnes Lake Tea House, which has magnificent views of Lake Louise on the way. The tea house was rebuilt in 1981, and it also has other trails branching out from there. We'll follow the beautiful lakefront trail, where we enjoy a small waterfall of glacial meltwater flowing into the lake. The same trail continues up to the Plain of Six Glaciers tea house built in 1924, and offers excellent views of Mount Victoria, Victoria Glacier, Mount Lefroy, and Lake Louise. And you could also continue another 1.3 kilometers to reach the Abbott Pass viewpoint with close-up views of the lower Victoria Glacier and the hanging glaciers on Mount Victoria. And Abbott Hut can also be seen as a tiny speck resting on the pass between the two mountains. And from the Plain of Six Glaciers Tea House, it's also possible to hike about 5 kilometers to the Lake Agnes Tea House, so the adventurous could reach both tea houses in a full day of hiking. This lakefront trail is beautiful with many picturesque views, and I recommend continuing this easy hike to the small waterfall at the back of the lake. If you are visiting Lake Louise, you must come very early for parking. During peak season on a normal year, Parks Canada recommends arriving before sunrise to secure a parking spot. And coming here, you must also see Moraine Lake nearby, although parking there is even more difficult. So if the lots are full, you may be able to catch a Parks Canada shuttle at the Lake Louise Park and Ride Overflow lot just 6 kilometers south on the main highway. During COVID, a number of services were disrupted. You could also consider arriving by bus, such as with the Rome Transit from the town of Banff. And a Hop on Banff tourist bus also runs between a number of locations in the Banff National Park, including Lake Louise, its village, the gondola across the highway, and Moraine Lake. So it would be best to plan ahead and make reservations for that. Notice the beautiful delta. This is glacial meltwater working its way into the lake. On our return, the sun will lighten this whole area and turn the lake a bright emerald green. See how the water is somewhat milky as it flows over the rocks, and that's due to the fine rock dust sediment ground up by the glacier, and it gives the lake its turquoise color. From here, this trail continues further up the mountain to the Plain of Six Glaciers Tea House. Thank you. If you enjoy my videos, I encourage you to subscribe to my YouTube channel and click the bell to be notified of new releases. It's free, and sharing with your friends is much appreciated.